Cleveland, Ohio, pre-attitude era. WCW is having a TV taping at the CSU Convention Center. My buddy calls me up and says, hey, I got free tickets to the wrestling show. We're going. I said, sweet. How did you get free tickets? He says, I drove down to the radio station, told them that I called yesterday and won a trivia question, and they just told me to come down tonight and pick up tickets to a wrestling show. So sure enough, all he did was tell them that he won some tickets to a wrestling show, showed his ID, and they gave it to him. So we go down to the CSU Convention Center. We get our signs ready. Tony Schiavone and Lee Marshall are in the ring. They're telling the audience, all right, guys, now's the time to put your signs up because we're going to start taping. Now, me and my buddy were holding a sign that said, Lee Marshall is white trash. And I promise you, the next 30 seconds happened in slow motion. Tony Schiavone starts scanning the audience, and then he zones in on me and my buddy. He starts cracking up. He taps Lee Marshall on the shoulder. Lee Marshall turns around, and you can see it plain as day, pretty much saying the words, that guy has a sign that says Lee Marshall is white trash. Lee Marshall zones in at us, gives us a scowl, and then gives us a middle finger. The show starts, intermission comes through, someone starts passing out flyers. It turns out tomorrow night, there's a ECW show at another venue in Cleveland. So sweet, we're going to ECW tomorrow. The evening winds down, my buddy and I go over to the airport Marriott because we found out that's where the wrestlers stay, is at the airport Marriott. We go inside the restaurant slash bar area. We sit down, get like something lame, like some potato skins that we're splitting. We look around, and the table next to us, we see Lee Marshall. And within the next few minutes, we see Raven and the Sandman walk up to Lee Marshall's table. We literally witnessed wrestling history being made. We watched Raven make the introduction from Sandman to WCW, and we were sitting at the table next to him listening to their conversation. I remember hearing Sandman saying, all I'm asking for is the same deal that you gave Scotty. Give me the same deal you gave Scotty.
Wow. There was so much happening in this phone call. I don't even know where to start. First of all, I don't think Sandman is making his deal with Lee Marshall. I don't doubt that that was Sandman getting introduced to WCW people and trying to get a hookup. But I don't know. In my head, Lee Marshall isn't the one giving out contracts. Although now that I think about it, Lee Marshall, AWA, Eric Bischoff, AWA. I'm sure Eric brought in Lee. Maybe he was Eric's middleman or second man. So actually, you do make a good point. The thing that I took away from this the best, though, was that grift that you had in the very beginning. Why did I never think of that? Because I did once win tickets from the Score Chicago sports-based radio station for WCW at the United Center when I was a kid by calling in. But why didn't I just think about going to the radio station and being like, hey, I won tickets? Genius. That's genius. Everyone listening, I want you to take notes. Great call. And one thing I've learned from being in AEW is that Tony Schiavone is the best. So, of course, he's going to point out that sign and show it to Lee Marshall. I also love great signs. Having a sign for the most obscure personality in WCW and then insulting him. If it was me, I would feel sad. If from an outsider looking in, I love it. And good on Lee Marshall for flicking you off. You deserved it. Hey, thanks for watching. That call was part of a whole podcast called Wrestling Anonymous. Listen to the whole thing weekly. Wherever you listen to your podcast, go subscribe. While you're at it, subscribe right here on YouTube to Colt Cabana's channel. Thank you.